Hi everybody, I'm Dr. Lakshmi Gayatri. Anatomy of the tongue and its clinical anatomy is the topic which we are going to discuss today. Tongue is an essential organ which is present in the oral cavity. It is a part of this oral cavity, but it is also present in the pharyngeal cavity. It does not contain bones and it is a solid conical muscular organ. It is used in many ways. It is helpful for the deglutition of food. It pushes the food into the esophagus. It has taste buds, so it is an organ of taste also. It is helpful in speech because without tongue nobody can speak. Nowadays it is helpful in medico-legal aspect because tongue printing can identify an individual. We will study the gross anatomy of the tongue under the following headings. We have to know about its location and its attachment, the various parts of the tongue and its features present in each part. Since it is a muscular organ, we should know about its muscles. Its blood supply and nerve supply and lymphatic drainage are very important. Its clinical anatomy also should be known. So under these headings, we are going to study about the tongue. The tongue is located partly in the oral cavity and partly in the pharyngeal cavity, which we have already discussed. Now we have to know about the attachments of the tongue. The picture which is being drawn is the sagittal section of the head, which shows the nasopharynx, oropharynx with the tongue. The tongue is present anterior to the oropharynx. The red color structure denotes the tongue. The attachments of the tongue are to two important bones, hyoid bone and mandible. Also, it is attached through its muscles to the styloid process, the soft palate and to the pharyngeal wall. And these are the attachments of the tongue. We have to know about the five parts of the tongue. They are the tip or the apex, the dorsal surface or the base, the inferior surface or the undersurface, the lateral margins, and the attached part or the root of the tongue. Now we will see the features of each part. The tip or the apex of the tongue comes in contact with the central incisor tooth. The dorsal surface or the base of the tongue is convex on all the sides, and from before backwards it is attached to the epiglottis in the oropharynx through two important folds, centrally placed median epiglottic fold and two lateral glossoepiglottic fold. Between the median and the lateral glossoepiglottic fold is a depression called as epiglottic valicula. The tongue is covered by the mucous membrane made up of non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. The dorsum of the tongue is divided into two parts by a V-shaped sulcus terminalis with a central depression or an opening called as foramen cecum. The foramen cecum represents the cranial part of the thyroglossal duct from which the thyroid gland is developed. The V-shaped sulcus terminalis divides the dorsal surface into an anterior two-third part called as presulcal part and a posterior one-third part called as postsulcal part or the pharyngeal part. The presulcal part of the tongue has projections in different shapes arising from the lamina propria of the mucosa. These are called as papillae. There are around four types of papillae present in the anterior two-third part of the tongue. Those are valid papillae, which are arranged in a single row just anterior to the sulcus terminalis, the fungiform papillae arranged around the lateral margins of the tongue, the filiform papillae or small conical projection present in the center of the anterior two-third part of the tongue, while the foliate papillae are two or three number present anterior to the valid papillae on the lateral margins. All these papillae are sensory in function, containing taste buds which are helpful in identifying the taste. These taste buds are absent in the filiform papilla, which is a point to be noted. The posterior one-third part of the tongue or the postsulcal part does not contain any such papilla. Instead, it has numerous lingual tonsils, which are collections of lymphocytes helpful in the immune mechanism of the tongue. Talking about the lateral margins, which is attached to the palatoglossal fold present at the junction of the anterior two-third and the posterior one-third part of the tongue. This palatoglossal fold forms the anterior boundary of the palatine tonsil. The attached part or the root of the tongue extends from the symphysis menti of the mandible to the body of the hyoid bone. Lastly, talking about the inferior surface, the undersurface of the tongue has four important features. There is a central fold called as frenulum linguae. On either side of this frenulum linguae, there are two other mucosal folds called as plica fimbriata. Between these two folds, there is a vein called as profunda linguae which drains the tongue. On the base of the frenulum linguae, there is a projection called as sublingual papilla which represents the opening of the submandibular duct in the floor of the mouth. These are the four important features present in the inferior surface of the tongue. So that completes about the features of the different parts of the tongue. Muscles of the tongue. They help in the movement of the tongue. There are two groups of muscles present in the tongue. They are extrinsic group and the intrinsic group of muscles. The extrinsic group of muscles are attached to the bones and they help to change the position of the tongue, while the intrinsic group are not attached to bones but they help to change the shape of the tongue. Let's see about the two groups of muscles. First, extrinsic group of muscles. The five extrinsic muscles are genioglossus, hyoglossus, chondroglossus, styloglossus and palatoglossus. The genioglossus is a fan-shaped muscle which forms the bulk of the tongue. It originates from the superior genial tubercle of the symphysis menti of the mandible and gets inserted into the body of the hyoid bone and also passes upwards to get inserted into the tip of the tongue. The main action is to protrude the tip of the tongue and also makes the dorsal surface concave. This muscle is also called as a safety muscle of the tongue because it saves the life of any person by preventing the backward fall of the tongue on the oropharynx. Otherwise, the respiration might get obstructed. The next muscle, hyoglossus, is a quadrilateral shaped muscle which arises from the hyoid bone and gets inserted to the sides of the tongue. Its action is opposite to genioglossus by making the dorsal surface of the tongue convex. The chondroglossus muscle is said to be the detached part of the hyoglossus muscle which has the same origin and insertion like hyoglossus. Its action along with hyoglossus is depression of the sides of the tongue. The styloglossus muscle is a muscle of the styloid apparatus which originates from the styloid process and gets inserted to the sides of the tongue. Its action is antagonistic to the genioglossus because genioglossus protrudes the tongue while the styloglossus retracts the tongue. The palatoglossus, as the name implies, arises from the palatine aponeurosis. And like all other muscles except the genioglossus, it also gets inserted to the sides of the tongue. Its action is to elevate the dorsal surface of the tongue. The intrinsic set of muscles are arranged in four pairs. They are superior longitudinal, inferior longitudinal muscles, transverse linguae and verticalis linguae muscle. The superior longitudinal is present in the dorsum of the tongue, while the inferior is present in the undersurface of the tongue. The tongue is divided into two symmetrical halves by a median fibrous septum. This fibrous septum is coronally oriented and gets attached below to the hyoid bone to form the hyoglossal membrane. The superior longitudinal muscle and the transverse linguae muscle gets originated from the median fibrous septum, while the inferior longitudinal muscle gets inserted into the median fibrous septum. The verticalis linguae muscle, as the name implies, is a vertical muscle which arises from the dorsum and gets inserted to the sides of the tongue. The length of the tongue is increased by superior longitudinal while decreased by the inferior longitudinal muscle. Similarly, the width is increased by the transverse linguae and decreased by the verticalis linguae muscles. Arterial supply of the tongue. Lingual artery is the chief arterial supply to the tongue. It is a branch of external carotid artery. The branches of the lingual artery like dorsal linguae and the profunda linguae supplies the entire parts of the tongue. Other arteries like ascending palatine and tonsil are branches of the facial artery. Also, the direct branch of external carotid artery named ascending pharyngeal artery also supplies the tongue. The venous drainage of the tongue is arranged in two sets, superficial and deep. The superficial veins accompany the hypoglossal nerve, while the deep vein accompanies the lingual artery, and finally they all terminate in the internal jugular vein. The nerve supply of the tongue is an important part to be discussed. Generally, nerve supply is divided into motor supply and sensory supply. With regard to tongue, the motor supply are three. They are somatomotor, secretomotor and vasomotor. Somatomotor means the motor nerve supply to the extrinsic and intrinsic group of muscles, and since these are skeletal muscles, it is termed as somatomotor nerve supply. Secretomotor supply means the motor supply given to the smooth muscles that is present in the glands of a particular organ. They are two sets of nerves. One is preganglionic, the other one is postganglionic. The preganglionic fibers generally arises from the nucleus present in the brain. Through few sets of nerves, it relays in the peripheral ganglion. From the peripheral ganglion, the postganglionic fibers arises and then supplies the gland, which helps to bring out its secretions. Vasomotor supply means the motor supply given to the smooth muscles of the main arteries which supply the particular organ. Usually they are sympathetic nerves. With regard to the sensory supply of the tongue, two senses is to be mentioned, that is general sense and special sense. General sense denotes common senses like touch, pressure, temperature. Special sense denotes taste. We are going to see the sensory supply for the anterior two-third, posterior one-third and from the posterior most valicula of the tongue. The motor supply to all the muscles of the tongue is given by the hypoglossal nerve except for the palatoglossus muscle, which is supplied by the cranial accessory nerve. The secretomotor supply is for the anterior lingual glands, whose preganglionic fibers are from superior salivated nucleus and postganglionic from the submandibular ganglion. The vasomotor supply given to the lingual artery is from the sympathetic nerves arising from the superior cervical ganglion. Coming to sensory supply, in the anterior two-third part of the tongue, excluding the circumvallate papilla, the general sense is supplied by the lingual nerve and the special sense is by the caudate infantine nerve. While the posterior two-third part, including the circumvallate papilla, both the general and special sense is given by the glossopharyngeal nerve. While the posterior most part, valicula, both the general and the special is given by the internal laryngeal nerve, a branch of superior laryngeal nerve, which in turn is a branch of the vagus nerve. The taste sensation from the caudate tympani of the facial nerve, the glossopharyngeal nerve and the vagus nerve is relayed in the nucleus of tractus solitarius present in the medulla. Finally, the proprioceptive sense from the muscle is relayed to the trigeminal nucleus. After the elaborate study of the nerve supply of the tongue, let us also know about the lymphatic drainage. Lymphatic drainage is very important because it is the only source of metastasis of the carcinoma of the tongue to other parts of the body. The tongue drains its lymph through four sets of lymphatics, namely apical group, marginal group, central group and dorsal group. The apical set drains the tip and the frenulum linguae to the submental lymph nodes and also to the submandibular lymph nodes. From these nodes, it is finally drained into the jugulodigastric and jugulo-omohyoid lymph nodes. The marginal set draining the lateral margins of the tongue and the central group draining the central part of the tongue drains into the submandibular group of lymph nodes. The central set undergoes a decussation where the lymphatics usually drains into the contralateral group of lymph nodes. Both the sets empties its lymph into the submandibular group of lymph nodes, which in turn goes to the jugulo-omohyoid and jugulo-digastric group. In case of dorsal set, which drains the posterior one-third part of the tongue, the lymph directly drains into the jugulo-digastric and jugulo-omohyoid node. The peculiarity of the lymphatics of the tongue are they do not accompany the blood vessels and the tip of the tongue has the richest lymph drainage. The principal lymph nodes of the tongue are jugulo-omohyoid and jugulo-digastric nodes. Now, we will also look into the clinical anatomy of tongue. Genioglossus, being the safety muscle of the tongue as already mentioned, goes for paralysis when given general anesthesia. So quickly an airway is inserted for an anesthetized patient to prevent the tongue from falling back. In mandibular fracture, there may be injury to the hypoglossal nerve of one side, which results in the paralysis and atrophy of one side of the tongue. So when the tongue is protruded, there will be deviation to the paralyzed side because of the unopposed action of the genioglossus muscle on the other side. Lingual carcinoma occurring in the anterior part of the tongue metastasizes only in a later stage. But when the carcinoma occurs in the posterior part of the tongue, the spread occurs at an early stage because it empties its lymph directly into the superior deep cervical lymph nodes. Hence, its spread occurs at an early stage. Tongue tie is a condition which interferes with the tongue movements and may also affect speech, which occurs due to the presence of a large frenulum. In such rare cases, a frenectomy is done to relieve the symptoms. Thank you.